When we were little, our grandparents, our mothers and fathers tell us about creation and what this earth means to us. This is not a piece of land that's valued in dollars and cents. This is a piece of land which is part of us. It is our mother. We can never sever ourselves from that breast that feeds us. The one that can give us everything we need in life. I have a right to protect my livestock.
In this stage of developing effective remedies for violation of human rights, a good example of this is a case that was brought in the Inter-American Human Rights System on behalf of the Western Shoshone Nation. In this case, the United States was found to have violated their human rights, and it expressly called on the United States to establish a new legal mechanism to determine fairly the merits of their land claims. And it also called on the United States to review its discriminatory practices with respect to extinguishing Indian land rights. This is an example of the tension that we need to overcome as we begin to build a truly dynamic international framework for indigenous rights. And so after this victory in the regional body of the OAS, we have gone to the Committee on the Elimination of Racial Discrimination in the United Nations.
Whose land? Whose land?
Our land!
Please help us and understand. No. No sale.
No more development.
No development. No more. When you ruin our mountains, our food, our resources.
The question of resources. Resources, whether it's minerals, oil, whether even if it's on my private property, it still doesn't belong to me, it belongs to the state. So these are some of the issues that that I think give rise to problems with the current text of the Declaration.
Well, the fear over land rights is really a fear which is based on past behavior by governments who have a long history of seizing land, taking land away from indigenous peoples. The track record of indigenous peoples is remarkable in the degree to which they have been the stewards of the land, in which they have taken care of the land, tried to preserve the land, tried to make sure that the kinds of practices that are instituted with natural resources are sustainable. The best guardians of the land for the entire nation have been, in fact, indigenous peoples. There's no evidence that what indigenous peoples want to do is to take resources away from other peoples. What they are fighting for is not to have resources taken away from them which are essential to their very existence as a peoples.
There is a growing understanding by many states that we cannot have truly secure, productive development and progress and security among states unless there is complete and fair compliance with human rights obligations.
Yamak disha yamak disha yamak pruk pruk komi mai no mano aram kadan yamak ka niyam hai yamak ka shay hai yamak ka shahar ma hum hasimo yamak shahar ma hai pahari ba yamak shahar ma hey homo sa yamak shahar ma yamak shahar ma kadan eji ka kura hey yamak ka ki yamak ka to bari uchan wa yaw so yamak hisyo shwani burisa.
Até hoje, e nós ficamos mais, cada vez mais bravos. Nós estamos ficando mais bravos ainda. Por isso, nós não queremos mineradoras.
Вот именно российскую делегацию не удовлетворяет или, скажем так, вызывает озабоченность, в частности, статья 26 текста декларации о правах коренных народов на землю, территории и природные ресурсы. Это немножко не стыкуется с российским законодательством в этой области.
The people in the Central Kalahari Game Reserve, they were threatened, they were told, If you don't move, we are going to send the soldiers. What happened is government officials hired people whose job was just to break down houses. So the people who were hired to break down houses would just go in, pack up their property, load it up, break down the house, and that was it. People are very sad and heartbroken. My people want to go back to the reserve. We want to go back, and when in the reserve, where they go besides the reserve, far from the police camp, until they find an opening to sneak in. When they are found out when sneaking into the reserve, they are kicked out. When you go into the reserve with containers of water, the water is emptied, it's thrown out. You are not allowed to go in carrying water and food. Even those who remain in the reserve, they are not allowed to use their culture of hunting and gathering. Those are the problems we face in my country. We are not the only ones. All the Basara or Bushmen living in other parts of the country have similar problems. These new settlements they've been put in, there's nothing happening there. Their children don't pass at the schools. The young and the old all have alcoholic problems. Their minds are poisoned and destroyed. They don't work as they used to when they were in the ancestral land.
In Navajo country, we consider Earth as our mother. In Navajo, we say Nasa Shema. And our prayers begin from her, Nasan Shema Kodohajon Dolel. And the earth is our mother to all of us. She allowed us to live on her, provided a sacred space for us. And for Navajo, it's between the four sacred mountains and Arizona, New Mexico, Utah, and Colorado. And we have specific activities connected to these specific places. And we cannot conceive ourselves as a people, no, outside of that.